and a big win for the BJP in Sikkim. 10 MLAs of the Sikkim Democratic Front have joined the BJP. The former SDF MLAs joined the party in the presence of BJP's working president JP Nadda and senior BJP leader Ram Madhav. All SDF MLAs except for the chief of the SDF and former Sikkim chief minister Pawan Kumar Chamling joined the BJP. Till now, Sikkim was the only state in Northeast India where the BJP was not in power. This shift propels the BJP status to the main opposition in the state, where it had not won a single seat in the recent assembly elections.
इस बार चुनाव में एसडीएफ के 15 स्थानों पर विजय प्राप्त हुआ, दो स्थानों पर एक ही उम्मीदवार दो-दो जगह चुनाव लड़े थे, इसलिए इफेक्टिव लेजिस्लेचर पार्टी का स्ट्रेंथ 13 विधायकों का रहा है, उसमें से 10 विधायक सब मिलकर निर्णय किए हैं कि एसडीएफ का जो लेजिस्लेचर पार्टी है वो भारतीय जनता पार्टी में शामिल होना है।
On to some sports news now. The BCCI has shortlisted 6 candidates, including current men's senior team head coach Ravi Shastri, who will be interviewed for the position of the next coach of the Indian cricket team in Mumbai on Friday. That's August 16th. The 6 candidates are former New Zealand coach Mike Hessen, former Australia all-rounder and Sri Lanka coach Tom Moody, former West Indies all-rounder and Afghanistan coach Phil Simmons, former India team manager Lal Chand Rajput, former India fielding coach Robin Singh and Ravi Shastri. Then, as decided by the Supreme Court appointed Committee of Administrators, the selection of the head coach will be done by a 3-member cricket advisory committee, which features former Indian cricketers Kapil Dev, Anshuman Gaikwad, and Shanta Rangaswamy.
Definitely, Ravi Shastri will be the front runner because of two reasons. A, he has the public backing of Captain Virat Kohli, and Virat Kohli is the most influential voice in Indian cricket right now. We have seen in 2017 when Anil Kumble was set to, you know, re-elected as the Indian coach, but he didn't get the job, even though he had the backing of Sachin Tendulkar, Saurav Ganguly, and VVS Lakshman, because Virat Kohli wanted Ravi Shastri. So, and if you look at the last 2 years, the way the coach Ravi Shastri has performed, his record is quite impressive. The team made it to the World Cup semi-final. They lost against New Zealand. Then the first time they won the test series in Australia. So I think Ravi Shastri will be the front runner. But at the same time, there are a couple of candidates, especially from the overseas, like the likes of Tom Moody and Phil Simmons. Particularly Phil Simmons. I think the Phil Simmons case will be very interesting, because in the next 2 years, India is going to participate in 2 T20 World Cup. And Phil Simmons is somebody who is the part of the World Cup winning team. He coached West Indies to a World Cup, T20 World Cup winning team, and he has worked wonder with the likes of Afghanistan and Ireland, and he's a new coach, he's in demand. So this will be very interesting, because Phil Simmons is a very young coach, and he has a proven credential as far as T20 cricket is concerned.
Well, flights out of the Hong Kong airport have been disrupted for the second day in a row. Yesterday, thousands of protesters occupied Hong Kong's international airport, forcing a shutdown. The airport reopened today, but flights out of the airport were cancelled due to the presence of the protesters. Over 200 flights have been cancelled. Mass unrest has rocked Hong Kong for 10 weeks now, and there are no signs of the protests abating. Protests started in response to a proposed extradition bill, which has now been suspended, but has evolved into a more demanding pro-democracy movement. When Michelle